that background, let's look at the quick impact area on the three broad sectors, the manufacturing, trading and the service sectors. And when you look at manufacturing sector, we have a chart here where we have all the creditable taxes in green color and non-creditable taxes in red color. So typically a manufacturer, when he buys goods intrastate today, there's an excise and VAT. That excise and VAT then gets replaced by CGST and SGST. So excise in your purchase bills as a manufacturer, instead of central excise, you will have a CGST. Instead of VAT, you will have an SGST. Today you get credits of excise, you will continue to get the credit of CGST. Instead of VAT, there's an SGST, again the same credits will be available. This is where you will see a change. In interstate purchases, there's an excise and CST against Form C. You charge 2%. If you are not able to give CFOR, then the vendor charges you 12.5%. This CST today is not available as a credit. Both of these taxes gets replaced by IGST, which is fully available as a credit. So this red part goes away, and that's an opportunity. That's a benefit which is available to the manufacturer. On import today, there's a basic custom duty. There's a CVD and an SAD. Instead of CVD and SAD, both of them gets replaced by IGST, which continues to be available as credit. On services, today you have service tax. Instead of that, you will have a CGST-SGST combination or an IGST combination, again available as a credit, so not a major concern. This is his procurement side. On the right-hand side, we have his sales side. When we are talking about on his sale of goods, we'll charge an excise and a VAT. Instead of that, he will have a C and an SGST, again available as a credit to the trader. Interstate sales, there's an excise and CST. Again, CST being a cost to the trader, that will no longer be cost. We will not have C form. So today we have a big surprise which happens at the time of assessment. At the time of sale, the customers say that we'll give you C form, so you charge 2%. After 3 years, when the assessment happens, C forms are not available. And because C forms are not available, at that time you have to pay 12.5. The customer is no longer available, or if he's available, he's not even paying you your basic value. So getting the additional 10.5% and the interest and the penalties becomes a big challenge, and it's a big nightmare for the marketing teams to keep on tracking these C forms and all. So that are things of the past. There will be no C forms. Instead of CST, you will have an IGST, which will be fully creditable to your customers. Exports, today also there are no taxes. Moving forward also there will not be any tax, so that's a good point. Stock transfers, today there's an F form and there's no tax. Moving forward, there's a little bit of a challenge. There are two views which are prevailing in the industry. One is to say that this stock transfer will be taxed under IGST. Another to say it is not taxed. We'll talk about it in detail when we go to the specific slides. As far as a trader is concerned, what all changes? And here you see a lot of change. For a trader, today when he buys goods intrastate, there's an excise and a VAT. He is not eligible for excise credit. If he is a dealer, he can pass on the credit as a first stage dealer. But he is not eligible for credit himself. That changes. Moving forward, excise gets replaced by CGST. And that CGST is available as a credit to the trader. Now this, from a trader's perspective, opens up an opportunity. Today, there is a lot of hesitation for a trader. If he registers as first stage dealer and passes on the credit, he can pass on. But when he does that, he has to mention the details of the manufacturer. He has to mention the price at which he has bought the goods and the excise duty embedded in it. Therefore, for a trader, his sourcing pattern and the profit gets disclosed to his customer. And this is one major challenge which traders face today. And they always complained about it. That if we want to pass on excise and if it's a large item, customers will want the excise credit. And therefore, they will force a dealer registration. And once you are dealer registered, the customer will immediately know the embedded margin. They will know that you are selling at 1 lakh, but you had purchased it only at 50,000. Because the excise component on that is only this much. From that, and full details are available in the first stage dealer invoice. Now, that is a big opportunity for a trader that goes away. He will be in a position to safeguard his profits. He will be in a position to safeguard his sourcing patterns. He may be sourcing from 10 places. He may not mention it to you. He may not need of dealer registration, and that I think is a big advantage as far as a trader is concerned. Interstate, both excise and CST become a cost to him today. Against that, you have an IGST which is fully creditable, so clearly a big positive side. On import, CVD is a cost, SAD refunds are available, but it's a long process. You have to file your bill of entry and give all those documents back to the customs authorities, and again at least a yearly process to get back the SAD refund. certification, and there are associated costs attached to it. All of that goes away. Instead of that, you straight away have an IGST, which you claim in your returns and adjust it against your output taxes. So all in all, on the procurement side, lots of benefits. Service tax today is a cost because input service is defined narrowly. If an input service is used for a trading activity, credits today are not available. Moving forward, instead of service tax, you will have a CGST, SGST and IGST, and those taxes would be available as a credit to the trader. So you can see lots of reds over here, which today are sunk cost, becoming a wash tax, becoming a creditable item in the future. So therefore, there is a lot of opportunity for a trader to really look at a reduction in price or an increase in his profit. Okay. Now, I am not even factoring the fact that the effective rate itself goes down. Actually, what is happening is 12.5 VAT and 12.5 excise, effective rate cumulatively is about 28-29%. That itself is likely to fall to 18. So there is a 8-10% reduction in the tax rate itself. Over and above that, you have a credit benefit over here, and therefore essentially there will have to be a reduction, a substantial reduction in prices. Whether it happens or not happens will depend on the person who is buying. How strong is he in negotiating his prices with the vendor, and accordingly it will result in a reduction in price. On the sales side, he is today charging VAT, that changes. He has to charge CGST as well as SGST. Till today, more or less, he is neutral to the central authorities, he is not registered with the central authorities. He will have to register and charge a CGST plus SGST, both of them available as credit to the customer. Interstate, instead of CST, we have an IGST, and the challenge of C-form collection goes away. Exports, no taxes. Stock transfers, the debate of IGST being applicable. Now we look at services. And in services today, typically service providers bear a cost of VAT and CST, which goes away. So that is very important. Excise gets replaced by, on the procurement side, gets replaced by CGST, credit available. VAT, today they are not eligible for credit. That will be available to them as a credit against SGST. So same way, interstate CST not available as a credit, now IGST fully available as credit. SAD is a cost for service providers, which will no longer be a cost, and IGST credits will be available. Here anyways it's neutral because everywhere the credits were available for service tax. On the income side, of course, they will be now exposed to the state level taxation. So your service tax gets replaced by CGST and SGST. Overall the rate increases from 15 to 18, but that's the challenge, larger challenge is that 18 gets split into 9 and 9, and for the 9 of the state, they will have to run around from pillar to post at the various state authorities and register and pay taxes at the respective states. So that's the broad impact on the service provider. So essentially, if you look at the impact, yes, for manufacturers, it will unlock credits, it will result in better alignment of your distribution and logistics chains, cascading impact of tax will go away, the C-form, H-form documentation will reduce, will bring back immediate uniformity across the states. So you don't have to worry about the different VAT rates in different states, different due dates, because the due dates and everything will be common, the return formats are common, and depending on the revenue neutral rate, the impact according to me would be largely positive for the manufacturers. Similarly, for traders also, it would be largely positive. Service providers, there's going to be a little bit of a challenge because the rate increasing from 15 to 18, so that 3% increase in rate, plus the additional compliance burdens. So that's going to be a complication for the service providers to some extent.